Welcome to Ask Al, presented by QuadPlus. So here's today's question. What do I see as the future of power electronics in drive systems? So very interesting question. If you look at technology and the underlying technology in today's semiconductors, primarily silicon-based. So we started with the SCRs in variable speed drives in the 70s and 80s. Then as we moved through the 80s, Darlington transistors became the device of choice. Towards the end of the 80s, IGBTs became available on a production basis. And then from IGBTs, we saw a proliferation of what I'd call CT, controlled thyristor devices. So it could be an SGCT, an IGCT. But the one thing they all have in common is that they're silicon-based. Now, looking at Moore's law, and as we went, where everything doubles over so many years, what we've seen with silicon, we've been able to get larger devices, handle higher voltages, but there's many people today that think that it's probably at its limit as to how fast we can switch it and how high a voltage it can support. So what's coming out in the market now are a new generation of devices that are called wide band gap devices, and essentially there's a wide gap in the atomic level between the valence band and the conduction band. So, and there's lots of information online that you can read about these, but the impact on our business in power electronics and certainly in drives is that these devices, whether it's a silicon carbide or a gallium nitride, have very, very low on impedance, on resistance, I'm talking in terms of milliohms, and are lightning fast, so much, much faster even than today's IGBT. Now, a lot of this development has been driven by the renewable energy and electric vehicle market, in that, there's a focus to get efficiencies up, 1% efficiency on a wind farm or a solar park is huge. Weight in electrical vehicles is huge. So there's this drive to make things smaller, lighter, faster, and less lossy. And that's what these devices bring to the table. I was recently watching a webinar where a 400 horsepower inverter based on wide band gap devices was as big as a shoebox. So I think as the electric vehicle market moves forward, the renewable energy markets move forward, we're going to see this new technology, and that technology is going to ultimately wind up coming into the drive market and the inverter market. So the impact, and as I've seen some of these devices, these prototype devices, one of the biggest challenges is how do you even connect to it? I mean, your wires start to be the same diameter, adding the diameters up, same size as the inverter. So perhaps the inverter starts to become part of the motor, where you just have an Ethernet connection to your motor. I don't know. But what I do know is that based on the data today and the devices that are available on the market today, you are going to see this new technology coming into our markets. And, one of the impacts that we're going to have to deal with, much like with IGBTs, where they first came out, and in the design world, we said, okay, these devices are great because I don't need an output reactor anymore. I mean, I can survive a short circuit because I can turn this device off in a microsecond. The Darlingtons that they were displacing, they took 20 microseconds, so you had to have a reactor to limit the current, give you time to shut the device down. So the IGBT was great, we can get rid of the reactor. Well then, guess what? We started getting motor failures. So, boom, back in with the reactor. Now, with these fast devices, you're going to have one of the real issues and one of the challenges is dealing with the noise. There's a tremendous amount of EMI, where we've had issues with motor cables failing. I think XPLE insulation for today is a great choice because it's going to help an installation down the road when these new technologies come out. So, in a nutshell, what we're going to see? We're going to see very small inverters. We're going to see inverters with very, very low losses. We're going to see inverters that can protect themselves incredibly well. So bolted short circuits on the output that you can extinguish the current before any damage is done to the device. So it's going to be exciting, and it'd be interesting to see how it all plays out. So that's my view. there's certainly a proliferation of these wide band gap devices, lower in the power range today, good voltage support, but as it's gone with every other device, I anticipate that the power levels will increase, and so will the levels of voltage that they can support. So we're going to see substantial changes in the power electronics and the inverter market coming up in what I would say would be the short in the short term, within the next 5 to 10 years. I hope that was helpful, perhaps create some conversation. And remember, as you move forward, always work safe, lock out, tag out, and test before you touch.